Hello everybody, my name is Brandon Hopkins. I run the Tech Hut YouTube channel and I am a Linode developer advocate. What we are going to be doing in this video is setting up a discourse community form website, a process that is surprisingly easy to do here on Linode. First of all, what is discourse? Simply put, discourse is one of the most popular free and open source community form website platforms that is in use today. And chances are you've probably been on a discourse forum and didn't even realize it. If you've been to discourse.mozilla.com, you have form.manjaro.org or discuss.codeacademy.com, just to name a few of them. So whether if you need to create a huge support form for a large organization, or you just need a small community-driven website for a group you're in, Discourse is a good option for you. And something that does make Discourse unique, unlike a lot of the other popular forum software that you could just install on a web host, Discourse actually requires you to set it up through a VPN. And this requirement is where Linode shines. So getting right into it, what we're going to want to do is log into your Linode account. But if you do not have an account with Linode, there'll be a link in the description where you can go ahead and get a $100 60-day credit. Again, if you click the link down below, you will get a $100 60-day credit to go ahead, try out Linode, and follow along with this guide. And go over to your dashboard. Up in the top corner, we're going to go ahead and click on Create Linode. From there, we're going to want to go over to the marketplace and go ahead and select Discourse. What this is going to do for you is actually install the operating system, a Docker instance, and Discourse within that Docker instance all for you. It makes it super easy. In this setup page, we actually have a couple different options to set up our mail server and some other site-specific settings for Discourse. If you already have an SMTP server and all that stuff, you could go ahead and input that now, but we're actually going to save this for closer to the end and actually do this through the Discourse setup script that is built in. Doing this a little later is going to allow us to properly make sure our domain's connected, get our email server set up, and actually be able to go through that script just to get familiar with everything. One thing I would recommend you do is go down to the limited sudo user and create a user for that. This right here is completely optional, but it does give you the opportunity to have an actual user profile instead of having to do everything under a root user. So for this, just go ahead and fill out whatever username you would like and then input your limited sudo user password. From here, you're going to want to ensure that you do not disable root access by SSH, just in case if you do want to do that. Under region, you're going to want to select the server that is probably closer to whoever your target audience is, whether that be yourself and a small group or the entire world. Now you can go ahead and scroll down and here we're going to go ahead and pick our plan. The minimum system requirements for a Discourse instance is 1 gigabyte of RAM. So technically just starting out and getting this set up initially, you only need to select the Nanode 1 gigabyte plan. And one of the things that makes Linode awesome is as your community grows, you get more signups and all that, you could go ahead and upgrade the tier of your Linode as need be. Now, if you scroll down, you'll have the option to pick a Linode label. The thing I would recommend you do with this is go ahead and put in the domain name that is going to be associated with the Discourse forms, whether that be something with a subdomain or a peer domain. Throughout this tutorial, I'm going to be using the domain name cloudtut.xyz just for example purposes, and so after this, I could just delete everything so I don't have to hide passwords. So from here, you scroll down, input your root password. Make sure that this is fairly strong and secure, because if you don't set up SSH keys, which we're not going to cover in this video, somebody can log into your server with just root, your IP address, and this password. So do make sure that it is a very strong one. And from there, if you go ahead and scroll down to the bottom, you will have some additional options. One thing I'd recommend you consider is backups, especially if you're going to have a larger community with a lot of different things going on. It's just good to have that option available to you. So then once you have everything filled out, you could go ahead and click on Create Linode, and then it's going to start booting up your server, provisioning everything, and actually installing the Docker instance as well as Discourse for you. So now what we're going to do is talk about domains, and there's going to be two main methods to go about this. One, if you already have a website on like a shared hosting platform, for example, and you want to go ahead and add this as a subdomain to a website that you already have running, and to actually set up that subdomain, all you're going to want to do first is copy over your Linode IP address for the instance that we just went ahead and created. Go over to your cPanel on your already existing web host somewhere else, scroll down to the domains section, and then click on the zone editor. From there, we could go ahead and go over to the domain that we want to add a subdomain to, click on plus a record to add an a record, and in this dialog box, all you're going to want to do is type in the domain that you want, for example, forms.techcut.tv in this example, and then below that, input the IP address of your Linode server. Now, alternatively, what we could do is go ahead and set up a domain name strictly on Linode using the Linode name servers. So to do this, what you're going to want to do is log into wherever you purchased your domain and change the name servers to the proper name servers. Generally, there are 5 name servers. It's ns1.linode.com 1 through 5. But the best way to get this, and one thing that we're going to need to do anyway, is add the domain on linode.com. So from your Linode dashboard on the side here, you'll see a section that says domains. Go ahead and click on that and you'll see all your current active domains. And from there, what you're going to want to do is go ahead and click on create domain. So from here, this is pretty straightforward. All you're going to want to do is actually input that domain name that you're going to want to use over on the node, add in the email address, and under insert default records, what you're going to want to do is go ahead and insert default records from one of my Linodes. And then under Linode, you're going to want to go ahead and select the proper one that you just created. And then when you create that, you'll be able to see your actual NS records, and then you can use those records over on your domain service provider to actually link this up properly. So now that we have our domain names properly set up and linked, what we're going to go ahead and do is set up an email server, because Discourse actually needs access to all the SMTP server information to go ahead and send out notifications, activation emails, and things like that. If we take a look at the official page here from Discourse, they actually do have a couple different suggestions for service providers, including Mailgun, SendGrid, and MailGen. What we're going to be doing in this instance is actually using Mailgun to do this, because it's what I have experience with and it's worked perfectly fine for me. But if you already have a service provider, you could just use that. Or if you already have an SMTP server on some other host, you could try to use that, but depending on their specific settings, it may or may not deem successful for you. So for this, we're going to head over to Mailgun. Go ahead and create an account and log into your dashboard. So from your Mailgun dashboard, what we're going to do is go over to domains, and we're going to go ahead and add a new domain. So on this page, you're just going to want to go ahead, type in your domain name, and click the appropriate domain region. And now this part is just a little bit more difficult. What we're going to need to do is actually confirm we own the domain and link it properly so this service can send out emails from our domain name. And to do this, we're going to have to add some TXT, MX, and CNAME name records wherever our domain name is currently linked to. So if you're currently using a subdomain like we did earlier and you already have a cPanel instance on another website, and you've already edited some name records to go ahead and actually link your Linode IP address to your domain name, that is where we're going to be going and editing these records. So just like before, we would want to go into our cPanel, go under domains, go to your zone editor, and then this is the location where you'd want to add the proper corresponding records. Just copy and paste them over, and you should be good to go. Now, if you're using the Linode name servers on whatever domain provider you're using, you can actually set all this up through Linode. So to do this, what we're going to want to do is head over to the actual domain name section within Linode, go over to the domain that we're currently working with, and just click on it. Like before here, we're going to be able to see all the NS records, but additionally, we're going to be able to add additional TXT, MX, and CNAME records through this section of Linode. So first, what we're going to do is go ahead and add both of these TXT records, and to do that, you just click on add a TXT record, and then for the host name, you're just going to want to paste over whatever is over on Mailgun, and then paste in the values. Your default hostname is your domain name, so on the node you might not see it show up within the actual tables, but I do promise it is there. So now we could go ahead and add our MX records. And this is pretty easy. We're going to leave basically everything at the default, but under the mail server, you're just going to copy and paste over the domains given to you from Mailgun or whatever service provider you're using. And it should be along the lines of mxa.mailgun.org or something like that. Now from there, one thing I'd recommend you do is go ahead and delete the default mail.yourdomain.whatever. As for this, we're going to be purely using Mailgun or whatever service as our mail server. So next, go ahead and add that CNAME record. It's email.yourdomain.whatever. And then for the value, it's going to be mailgun.org or whatever it's telling you to input. And from there, we could go ahead and click on verify DNS settings. And if you had no issues and everything was done properly, it should take you to the overview for that domain name. You could also double check to make sure it's verified by going over to your domain dashboard and making sure that there is a green check there. Now, one thing we're going to do is actually create a custom domain for our discourse instance. The default domain name is postmaster at whatever your domain name is, and we want something different. The example I'm going to use is noreply@cloudtut.xyz. So to do this from your Mailgun dashboard, go over to domain settings, go over to SMTP credentials. And then from here, we're going to want to go ahead and add a new SMTP user. Here, we're going to input the domain noreply and create the new credential. Now from here, it's not going to show your password, but what we're going to do is go ahead and get it, copy it somewhere else so we could go ahead and use it later. And if you need to get your password, you can simply go ahead and click on reset password. Click reset password again, and then you'll see in the bottom corner a new password has been generated, and then you could go ahead and just click copy and copy that password to your clipboard. And from here, just so you have it, you could go ahead and open up Notepad or whatever text editor you use and save that password in there. So for the most part, we're actually done with the email server settings. I do recommend you keep that tab open because we are going to need that SMTP server information in just a little bit. But what we're actually going to do now is head back over to Linode. And we're going to go ahead and go to our main dashboard for the domain name or the node that we're currently working with. And you could go ahead and SSH into a terminal or however you like to connect to it. Just for this demonstration, I'm going to be launching the LISH, the Lish console, and inputting all the commands and anything I need to do through there. So you may need to log in when you first open this up. I'm just going to log into that sudo user I created. Additionally, if you'd like to, you can just log in as a root user. And then from there, I'm going to do a change directory to the /discourse directory and run a quick ls. And here you can actually see some of the scripts and programs that we're going to be interacting with, including the discourse setup. So from here, what we're going to do is type in sudo /discourse-setup, and that is going to launch the configuration wizard. And that is actually going to begin our setup process. After everything downloads, extracts, and is ready, we can actually begin the process of setting up all the information. So the very first thing is your host name, and we can see our default Linode domain name there. What we're going to want to do is change this to whatever domain name that we've been setting this up to work with for the first portion of this guide. And for my instance, that's going to be cloudtut.xyz. And what this is actually going to do is check your domain name to make sure everything is set up correctly and it's properly linked to the server. And if everything is correct, it's going to say connection to your domain name has succeeded. From there, we're going to want to input an email address for our administration account. Now, this does not have to be that no reply email. This actually should be your personal email that you actually want associated with your account on this server. So for me, I didn't even use an email with the same domain name. I used my personal business email just for an example. And now after that, we're going to want to go ahead and get our SMTP server address. And this is what I was talking about when I said you should keep that tab open so we could get some of this information from there in a little bit. So actually navigating over there, we can see our SMTP domain name is smtp.mailgun.org. So we could go ahead over here, paste it in, hit enter. And then for the SMTP port, I do recommend you just keep it at the default of 587. That is Discourse's preference. Now for the username, we're going to go ahead and use that login that created that no reply at our domain name. So go ahead and paste that on in there. And then for the password, you're going to want to open up your notepad or wherever you saved the password, give that a copy, and go ahead and paste it on in there. When you hit enter, it's going to ask you what you want your notification email to be. And for this, we're going to input the same email as our username, and that's that no-reply@cloudhut.xyz. And now this is optional. This is just for Let's Encrypt warnings. What I'm going to do here is just input my normal email address because I want to get those warnings. And here we have another optional setting. This is the MaxMind license key. You could go ahead and input that if you would like to. So from here, after you hit enter, what it's going to do is give you a list of all these settings that you've inputted thus far. So run through that, make sure everything looks correct. And if it does look good, go ahead and hit enter. And from there, what it's going to do is actually begin setting up just about everything. And this process may take a little bit of time. So just sit back, relax, and watch the magic through the console. And now once everything's all done, what we could do is head over to our web browser and go to your domain. So I'm going to go to cloudtut.xyz. And from here, you can see, congratulations, you installed Discourse. So from here, we're going to go ahead and click on the register button, and you're going to go ahead and select your admin email. It should be the email that you inputted during the actual setup process. And then give yourself a username. This is your server, so you could pick really whatever you want, and give yourself a password. It has to be strong, at least 15 characters. Now from there, it's going to ask you to confirm your email, and this is where you're really going to see if everything was set up properly. It might take anywhere from 2 to 3 minutes, especially for the very first email. So watch out for that. When you do get it, it should look something like this. And if you do not get that email, unfortunately, what you're going to need to do is figure out if any of those settings were improper, make sure everything is set up correctly, and rerun that Discourse setup script that we previously just ran and try again. But when you do actually get that email, go ahead and click on the link in the email so it can confirm your email and take you to the Welcome to Your Discourse Setup page. First, what you're going to want to do is go ahead and select your primary language. And then from here, you're going to want to give your community a name, give it a short description via a short sentence and a couple of words. From there, we're going to want to give it a mission statement. Now, it really doesn't matter what you put here from the get-go. This is going to be embedded into an actual topic later that you could go ahead and edit. But if you want to, you go and be creative here and fill this out as you see fit. Now the fourth page is access. So you can pick if you want to be a strictly private invitation only form, or if you want to give it public access and allow users to sign up at their free will, or if they need invites, things like that. Next, you're going to set up your contact email and your contact web page so people can know how to reach you. And for automated messages, you can set this as a system automated message, so the account profile will be system, or you can set it so your profile is where people are going to be getting these automated messages from. And these automated messages can be anything from warnings, bans, people getting specific rewards and badges, things like that. Next is some organizational stuff. So you're going to want to put in a company name, governing law, and city for disputes. Depending on what you're actually doing, this may or may not be that important. So just fill this out with whatever information you see fit. And now this is where we're going to actually start to have a little bit of fun. You can obviously get other themes from GitHub and things like that. But here you could go in and pick the actual color scheming and some options of the default theme. So for example, here we have shades of blue. You could go with something like dark rose. You go with just a default white. But I think for this little tutorial here, I'm going to go with gray amber. And I'm going to switch both the body and header font to Ubuntu. Now for the homepage style, again, like everything else here, you could change this later. And you are going to want to play around with this to figure out exactly what you like. But this is going to be how your actual default homepage will display. Just for this example, I'm going to go ahead and keep this on latest topics. Next, we have some logo stuff. So if you already have PNGs and all that of your site logos, you could go ahead and add those now, both the primary and square logos. Because as you shrink your site down a little bit, the actual logo will change. So you can put that now or go ahead and go with the default. And same goes with the next page. We have both the icon browser and the larger icon for mobile phones. You could change that now if you'd like to, or keep the default and change it later. So for the next page, we could go ahead and invite some people if you would like to. You could give a moderator permissions from the get-go, or just invite them as regular members. And once you do that, your discourse is ready. Everything is set up and good to go. If we actually go over to the homepage of our website, it's going to take us through a little tutorial thing just to get familiar with some of the user interface. But here it is. Everything seems to be set up just about perfect. Now, that was basically the bulk of everything we needed to do. But before we end off here, one thing you're definitely going to want to do is add plugins to your site. So I'm going to quickly show you how to do that. And we're going to be testing this out with the Discourse Reactions plugin. On all these plugin pages, it's going to give you a link to a tutorial on how to do this. It's a very easy process. But what we're going to want to do is open up our console once again. Make sure you're CD'd into the proper directory, and that is /var/discourse. And from there, I'm just going to go to this plugins tutorial page and copy and paste this little line of code. It's just going to nano into our containers directory and edit the app.yml file. Now, in this actual app.yml file, you're going to see a lot of things that are familiar, including all the SMTP server stuff we put in, just about everything. And if you really needed to, you could edit a lot of your site settings here as well. But I do recommend you do most of this through the actual dashboard on your website when possible. But to actually install a plugin, what we're going to want to do is go down to where it says plugins, go here, and under the section that says CMD, and we can see Git clone and then the Docker manager. Right now, that's currently the only plugin installed. And just to add another one, all we're going to do is add a new line, hit space enough times, do /git clone. And then what we're going to want to do is paste in the URL, the .git URL for the plugin we want to go ahead and add. So to actually do that, we could go over to the GitHub page for the plugin that we want to install. Under code and HTTPS, you could just copy that URL right there and paste it in right below the other plugin that we already have installed. Now from here, what we're going to want to do is run a rebuild script. Now, doing this won't actually affect any already existing topics, user profiles, or anything like that. All this is going to do is go ahead and install those plugins for us and actually enact any other changes that we made to that YML file. So you're just going to want to do sudo /launcher/rebuild-app, hit enter, and that's going to begin the process of rebuilding our forms. Now, if you start getting a lot of people on your forms, you're going to want to be careful with the frequency that you're going to be doing this, because there will be about a minute or two in which your site may be inaccessible while it's doing this rebuild. But now that our site is rebuilt, we could go ahead and make sure our plugin is installed. And to do that, we're just going to want to go over to our admin dashboard, wait for it to load up here, go over to plugins, and below here, you could see we have Discourse Reactions installed. If we wanted to, we could go over to the settings and manipulate the actual settings for that plugin. And just like that, we now have our very own Discourse instance running on our Linode server. Now, this was just the basic setup. There's so much more you could do with this. You could add themes, plugins that do absolutely anything you'd want it to do. You can fork themes and customize the CSS, a whole bunch of stuff. So what we're going to do is go ahead and link to a couple different resources down below, including the official text version of this install guide, just in case if you need any commands or anything like that. So if you enjoyed this guide, make sure you like this video. If you have any questions, comments, or concerns, go ahead and leave them down below. With all of that, I hope you all have a beautiful day, and goodbye.